My first best friend was a boy from the Dominican Republic named Daniel Toussaint Duvalier. We met when we were 18 years old, and we bonded over our love for adventures, our passion for dancing, our love for fried food. We've been best friends ever since. I go back to the DR every summer to get my ass squeezed by my abuela, te está poniendo gorda y linda, mija. And to get made fun of by my cousins, who always laugh at me when I try to speak Spanish, tu habla como una gringa. And to listen to English stations in the car with my uncles, they're always trying to play Michael Bolton and the Foreigners, and because that's what I listen to. No, that's not what I listen to. And they're always surprised when I make pollo guisado. They don't understand me. The only person who understood me was my best friend, Daniel Toussaint Duvalier. He was a boy who understood what it was like to be from two different worlds and who struggled with it just the same. Struggled with it even more. Daniel Toussaint Duvalier, a middle name passed down through generations, celebrating the hero of the Haitian Revolution, François Dominique Toussaint Louverture. I don't know if you've ever seen a painting of Toussaint, but he's fine as hell. Just like Daniel. Well, actually, Daniel looked like the actor Jimmy Jean-Louis, and he played Toussaint in the French miniseries. Fine! And Daniel just looks just like him, so the name fits. Daniel was born in my hometown of Managuayabo to Haitian parents who immigrated to the DR in the summer of 1985. So I was 18, getting ready to head off to college, and you know, I headed off to DR just like all my other summers previous to that. And you know, I'm thinking it's gonna be just another summer in DR, not really all that eventful, but then I met Daniel. He winked at me as he was leaning on his pasola and I was walking across the street to the banca with my aunt to buy another losing ticket. And so I asked my cousin, like, who's that cutie over there on the bike? And she's like, ew, him? He's not cute. You Dominican green guys have weird taste in men. The thing about Daniel is that he's cute. I mean, everybody can see that. Nobody can deny it. But she had a problem with him because he's black. That's all. And the thing is that my cousin, she's black too. But she thinks she's on some Mariah Carey shit, and she ain't. Effects of colonialism, effects of the Caribbean, effects of our broken relationship with blackness, missing pieces of a confusing puzzle, borrowed identities, lost identities, it's too complex. Don't get it twisted though, I mean, Daniel was really popular with the ladies. Everybody thought that we were boyfriend and girlfriend and all of that, and really I just didn't want to be involved with somebody that was just so desired by everybody, so we just decided to keep it friends. Daniel and I, we used to ride all over the city with his pasola. Okay, we used to try to find vintage Jordans in La Duarte. We used to go to Elias Piña and we would enjoy the market and dance to Rara and Gaga and Los Tiempos de Carnaval. Daniel taught me how to dance salsa under the shade, listening to Frankie Ruiz. And we would drive to Jaina and he taught me how to peel the mangoes bottom to top, not top to bottom. I mean, he just taught me how to have a love for my country, you know? Even though sometimes I felt left out, he didn't make me feel like a gringa dominicana. And he loved Haiti, and he made me feel like I was a part of it too. We listened to Compa all afternoon, Nemour Jean-Baptiste, and then we would switch it up and dance bachata, Marino Perez, and we would dance to all of it all summer long. We would go to his house for lunch, and we would have Mai Moulin with sauce panois, and then sometimes we go over to my house and we would have cheng cheng con habichuela y chivo guisado. Oh, it was so good. These were just beautiful summers. In the moments of identity crisis on the island, you know, Daniel would just always tell me that it's okay to embrace both sides. It's okay to come from two different worlds, because to come from two different worlds just means that you get to live two different lives in one lifetime. He was proud to be Haitian Dominican, and he hoped that one day, you know, the two countries would celebrate their differences and connect in and their similarities. He told me that DR and Haiti are two unique countries with beautiful people who just don't understand each other. Two beautiful countries filled with hardship and earthquakes and poverty and corrupt government, disorganization and color and art and food. Two countries that never give up. Two countries filled with incredible people, good people, imperfect people. And with a loving, repairing brotherhood, we could be like two super countries. He was hopeful that he would see this in his lifetime. So the next day, he picked me up on his Fasola, and he was wearing a cape of the two flags like tied together, and he looks like some sort of superhero. So we rode through the city, Daniel Toussaint Duvalier, with his pride on his back, ready to share it with the world.
Jésus, levez sous Jésus, ma ouais, plaisir belle.